Good evening.
Good evening.
We are going to now call the Dayton NAACP 2016 annual meeting to order. Another year is upon us, and we are delighted that the Lord has given each one of us another year to say hello once again. This is the time for Christmas season. Tis is the season to be jolly. I guess the annual meeting is a kickoff to that, because this coming Sunday is Christmas. So we're going to start our meeting off, as they say, with prayer. And as everyone knows, the Bible says to pray for your leaders. And as we pray for our leaders, I want you all to think about a scripture that comes to mind, which is 1 Timothy 2:1-2, where the Bible does say to pray for our leaders. So at this time, I will ask that Reverend Branham lead us in an opening word of prayer.
Bow our heads. Father God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we come at this time in this hour. First of all, Lord, we just want to say thank you. We thank you, Lord, for another opportunity you have given us that we can come together during this Christmas season to conduct our business at the NAACP. And Lord, we just pray your blessing upon each one that's here. And we ask, Lord, that you continue to allow them to do the things that they need to do, the things that will be pleasing in your sight. We pray for our president and his cabinet. We pray for this meeting, Lord, that everything we do it decent and in order, that you be well pleased with everything that takes place here. But it's a privilege and opportunity that we can come together during this Christmas season, and as we are leading up to the celebration of your son Jesus on this Sunday morning, as we take time to celebrate his birth. And we thank you that we are here to be able to witness that for another year. So be with us and stand by us right now. We're going to put this meeting in your hands right now and let you just be in charge and just touch your hearts and minds, and let us continue, Lord, to do the will that we need to do, to continue to help our community and to those around us. We pray for those that may be on their way too, Lord. Give them safe travel here. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Thank you. Previous minutes. Well, before we go to the minutes, I just want to tell you about some of our meeting norms. We commence each meeting with prayer, as you just seen there. We are to adhere to our meeting schedule, except when common agreement that we extend the time. The agenda today will be followed unless there is overwhelming decision to address a different issue. Respect each participant's right to voice his or her opinion. However, it will be appreciated if their opinion is communicated in a respectful manner. Turn cell phones on vibrate. If you receive a phone call, please leave the meeting area while answering the call. Thank you very much. Abide by brainstorming rules when applicable. Each volunteer is valuable to achieving the unit mission, vision, goals, and objectives, and should be treated as a professional and with respect. Disrespect, embarrassment, put downs, and personal attacks are unacceptable. Each meeting will follow the Constitution of the NAACP and bylaws for units. Local bylaws and Robert's Rules of Orders. Lengthy discussion items should be tabled, sent to a committee for disposition. And then at this time, I need a vision statement of our organization. Is that the Dayton Union NAACP vision is to fulfill the dream of the Civil Rights Act of 1964 by capitalizing on the second A of the NAACP, which stands for advancement. We are forever grateful to our forefathers and foremothers who have fought the good fight so there could be political, educational, economic, and social equality of rights for all Americans. We salute them for their bravery. So this time we're going to call our secretary up, Ms. Clary Ray Thompson, to give the previous minutes.
Thank you, President. Good evening.
Good evening.
We're going to do the roll call of attendance to see who's all here. All right? So when you hear your name, I just need you to say it loud and clear. Okay? All right, we're all in agreement. President Derek Fuller.
Present.
Reverend Herman Branham, First Vice President.
Present.
Second Vice President Rosa Smith.
She said she was on her way.
Third Vice President Tom Roberts.
Excused.
Madam Secretary Claire Thompson. Present. Loretta Williams, Assistant Secretary.
Present.
Treasurer Jamie Rippey.
Present.
Tanea Bailey.
Excused.
Alana Beans.
Present.
Stacy Benson Taylor. Chris Courtner. Ludell. Eric.
Excused.
Eric Ellington Sr.
Present.
Gene Ford.
Here.
David Fox.
Here.
Arnetta Gary.
Here.
Latoya Howard.
Excused.
Cedric McGee.
Present.
Marvin Mitchell.
Excused.
Dr. Carl Moyer.
Right here.
Hey. Reverend Io.
Here.
Attorney Kenneth Page.
Excused.
Carolyn Perkins.
Here.
Demetrius Rush. Chris Shaw. Deborah Smith. Willie Terrell Jr. Destiny Ray Walker. Anthony Whitmore. Diana Williams. Lisa Beth Willis. Roland Winburn. And this will conclude the roll call for 1219.
Thank you for the roll call. Previous minutes.
Previous minutes as follows. The last general meeting, the subject was President's Briefing with Dayton Police Department. The general membership meeting minutes, November the 28th, started at 6:09 p.m. Prayer was offered by Reverend Herman Branham. Roll call of attendance and the previous minutes were both read by Madam Secretary Claire Thompson. Chairman Io accepted the minutes and the roll call of attendance was accepted as read. First VP Reverend Herman Branham, second, the motion carried. Treasurer's report. Treasurer's report was read by Herman Branham. See October's budget report. Second VP Rosa Smith accepted the treasurer's report as read. Chairlady Ludell second. The motion carried. President's report, see written report. He acknowledged the members for good attendance. He reminded the executive members to provide highlights for the year's events, which is today that you're going to experience. Congratulated those who were elected into position for the 2017 year. President moved for the adoption of his report. Chairman Cedric McGee accepted the adoption of the report. First VP Reverend Herman Brannon accepted the motion carried. Criminal statistics was read by Sergeant Chad Miller. Vice President's report from the first, second, and third, there was no written report, but verbal reports were provided. Unfinished business, none by the executive committee. New business, Thanksgiving service to be held December the 11th at Zion Baptist Church. The meeting adjourned at 6:47 p.m. It was also scribed by Madam Secretary Claire Thompson, and this will conclude this reading of the minutes. Thank you.
You heard the reading of the minutes. What is your pleasure? Moved by Chairman Courtner. Is there a second? Second by Chairman Terrell. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carried. Treasurer's report.
right, this is the treasurer report for November. Regular membership, $900. Life membership, $6,675. The Freedom Fund, $27,650. Interest received for this month, $18.40. Total monthly income, $37,993.40. And then total expenses for this month is $78,974.30, leaving us a deficit of the month of $40,980.90, leaving us in the bank $127,456.14. All right, we're going to go over to our financial report here. Just some of the highlights that we've had over the past year. Submitted the NAACP annual financial report to the NAACP financial department on a timely basis. Provided transparency financial information to the organization's stockholders, members, community business leaders, governmental agencies, so potential donors can understand the organization's business and how we use our resources. Also worked with President Ford to develop an annual budget, as well as closely monitor the revenue and expenses that occur against the initial budget. Next, we prepare monthly financial statements for the organization members. Next, we stay knowledgeable of the organization's financial policies in accordance with the NAACP Constitution and the bylaws for the units. Next, once appointed to the Office of Assistant Treasurer, I met with the Assistant Treasurer and the current treasurer, as well as with President Ford, to get educated on the various responsibilities of the treasurer duties. Also answer questions that might arise so that I can have a clear understanding of the job. Then lastly, I met with the treasurer-elect, Mr. McGee, and the office manager, Ms. Seiler, to ensure a smooth transition. Thank you. Move for adoption of my report.
Move by Chairman Cordner, second by Reverend Ayo Ongulule. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signal by saying aye. Those opposed, motion carried. Thank you very much. And as you can see on the chart up there, in terms of the Treasury report, through the first was since 2007 to 2016, we actually had a surplus of close to $77,000 in the five different administrations that we have been engaged in over the past 10 years. So $77,000 in 10 years, I think that deserves a round of applause. President's report. And you'll see some of the highlights on the board. I'm going to just pick those, but we have a budget surplus of $76,808 since being elected president on November 12, 2006. I had an opportunity to raise $15,285 in membership money so far this year. Now, I moderated a Dayton Union NAACP monthly community meeting entitled Consequences of Life's Choices. Also moderated one called President's Briefing on National Convention Takeaways, as well as a President's Briefing with the Dayton Police Department. Hosted the Dayton Union NAACP Update TV show with special guest Montgomery County Chairman Mark Owens and Montgomery County Republican Party Chairman Phil Plummer. Presented a citation of honor to 8 deserving citizens and or organizations for commendable work in their respective profession. Presented a resolution to 3 families who have lost loved ones throughout the year, and also established a Dayton Union NAACP collection at Wright State University. So if there's anyone who actually has some material at your home in terms of Freedom Fund books, minutes, anything that you may have in your possession, you can feel free to take those to Wright State University, and that we have an archive there, so you can do that, and then that way that'll continue to build up the library there on behalf of the Dayton Union NAACP. Also, attended the NAACP National Board meeting to ensure that the Move Forward Thurgood Marshall NAACP High School chapter was chartered. They were officially chartered on February 20th, 2016. I was honored to administer the oath of office to the first elected officers and advisors of the Move Forward Third Good Marshall NAACP High School chapter. Went through the Dayton Police Department simulator training to understand split-second decisions that police have to make when it comes to various situations. Organized a meeting with Lieutenant Colonel Mark E. Acton, Assistant Chief and Deputy Director of the Dayton Police Department, Lieutenant Colonel Matt Carper, Assistant Chief and Chief of Operations for the Dayton Police Department, and Major Eric A. Henderson, Division Commander of the West Patrol Operations for the Dayton Police Department, along with Criminal Justice Chairman David I. Fox, to discuss several cases that have come into our office recently. As a result, we will start having quarterly meetings and calls as needed starting in 2017. You represented our client, Stephen Wright, at the Ohio Civil Rights Commission hearing at Wright State University. Held a meeting with Ben Glassman, U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of Ohio, to formally establish a working relationship and to receive an update on the John Crawford III case. We are still pursuing justice for the John Crawford family. And as many of you may know, the former U.S. Attorney resigned and took another position elsewhere. So I want to make certain that we did not lose steam as relates to staying on top of this particular case. Followed up with Scott Inske, Superintendent of Caring City Schools, to receive an update on the implementation of diversity training throughout his district. He provided a brief summary as well as full comprehensive outline of the training that will be conducted by NCCJ at the request of the Dayton Unit NAACP. So that was in direct relations to the Confederate flag case, where we were highly successful at negotiating a settlement agreement with Kettering City Schools to change their policy as relates to allowing the students to carry the Confederate flag on their property. So, and as a result of that, we also requested them to have diversity training throughout their district, which is currently being done as we speak. Met with Sheriff Flo Plummer, Chief Deputy Rob Strick, and Major Darrell, along with Dayton Unit NAACP Criminal Justice Chair Reverend David I. Fox, to discuss two pending cases we have with the Sheriff's Department. So those are just some of the things that that I've been engaged in so far this year. And I move for adoption of my report. Moved by Chairman Cortner. Second by John Chapman. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carried. Before I turn over to first VP Branham, I just want to acknowledge two people inside the audience, one being former president of the Dayton Unit NAACP, Attorney Richard Austin. Can you please stand and be recognized? And the other is former president of the Dayton Unit NAACP, Floyd B. Johnson. Please stand and be recognized. Thank you. First, we run them.
Good evening again.
Good evening.
This year has been pretty challenging for me, but I had some interesting challenges to me. One was I met with the Greater Dayton Baptist Association of Baptists to get them involved with our Dayton NAACP affairs. And right now, you know, this is a Caucasian organization. I'm trying to work with them to get them involved with us. I hope they will come aboard. I think this is a year that they really need to be involved with us to kind of understand what's going on. And as we are going to be faced with some issues in 2017, I'm sure. So I have met with them on a couple occasions, and sometime after the first year, I will be meeting with the local person here, Steve, as well as the head of the organization, which is housed out of Columbus, Ohio, here at a Dayton office here. I also mentored and trained students at the Life Skills Center of Dayton to assist them with good work ethics. Now, the Life Skills, if you're not familiar with it, it's organization, you know, where, you know, where 17-year-old, 16, 17-year-old young folks have either been expelled from school or put out of school or whatever, or just quit. And so this Life Skill is a center where they can come together, and they have different teachers for all classes, which helps them to, you know, get their regular GED credits, as well as training them to have some skills so they will become employable and good citizens once these skills are met. And I was given a challenge of working with the, with both male and female, on working with the hands. I used to teach industrial arts, so my task was to teach them how to build and teach them how to make items. And right now, you know, we're making a bunch of dog houses that's going to some of the pet stores, and the monies that those houses will sell for will go back to the organization so they can continue to function and do what it is that they have to do in order to train these young people different skills. And they have, that was my challenge with them. They have other skills that other teachers was instructed to do. Also, I continue to work with our Dayton Baptist and Pastors Ministry Union in order to have them to really get the parishioners more involved, you know, with our organization. And this is a tough crowd. And I'm doing what I can to hope that they will come aboard, because with their help and their leadership, we certainly can be more powerful. We can be stronger than what we are right now. So I haven't given up on them. But I will continue to work with them. Then last but not least, I also spearheaded a 2,000 men march against domestic violence here in Dayton, Montgomery County area. And this event issue was held in Trotwood at the Trotwood Madison Park here. And of course, the mayor, she was very much involved, the police department and fire department, they all come aboard to work with us on that. And next year we're planning a much bigger and better event. We will probably have it at the government center where more persons can become involved. And also the company that I've been employed by for years, Allstate Insurance, now they're asking me to try to get something set up because they want to donate money. And they're counting on me to get some things set up, organized, so that they can come aboard and give us some grant money in order to help out with this violence, because you know this domestic violence, it's really on a rampage, and we're trying to do what we can to let people know that you know, as our community, we're just as much involved as they are, because when we first started, all that we have is the one location. So I'm hoping we can branch out next year, also go into Englewood and Clayton and still keep the Trotwood. They have four locations south, but I'm trying to bring more here so we can become more involved and let them know we stand up for this, and let them know that we will not tolerate that, so we'll do what we can. Thank you. This time I'd like to move for the adoption of my report.
Moved by Second VP Smith. Who seconded? Arnetta Gary. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion carries. Second VP Smith, who is also our Health Committee Chair.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
As introduced, my name is Rosa Smith, and I serve this illustrious, wonderful organization as the Second Vice President and the Health Committee Chair. So as reported there, I report monthly to the Executive Committee and the General Body, support the President and the Executive Committee in the parliamentary process and actions. I attended and actively participate in the state conference this year, which was in Columbus, Ohio. As far as health goes, I moderated the Dayton Unit NAACP monthly committee community meeting, which was entitled Family Dentistry, Birth to Early Years. And our guest speakers were Dr. Robert Davis, who has since passed on, and his partner, Dr. Truman Martin. They did a wonderful job in addressing all of our questions. I really, really appreciate that, because a number of us at this stage are looking at dentures and you know, partials and all that kind of thing. So that was a good thing. I provide health recommendations every month to the Dayton Unit General Body. And this month I shall reiterate what I have probably so many times, and that is we must watch what we eat. We must be our own guardians of our health and our bodies. We have to do it. We don't have to be the fattest or most unhealthy subgroup in the nation. We just don't have to do it. There's things that our mothers and fathers and foreparents and so forth taught us that we know how to take care of ourselves. So that's my ringing echo. And lastly, I believe I've modeled good health practices, and I push the same to the general body. And overall, if anybody were giving us a grade, and if it were me, I would say we do pretty good. I appreciate you guys. So that is the end of my report, and I would recommend that we do the same all throughout our lives, and that we should teach our children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren and neighbors and everybody to do the same. That salt thing, that blood pressure thing, that does not have to be ours exclusively. We can share that, or we can eradicate that. And we just have to decide in our minds and in our hearts that we're going to do better. So that is my report, and I move for adoption of my report, Second Vice President and Health Committee.
Moved by Chairman Terrell, moved by John Chapman, second by Willie Terrell. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion carried. You know, sometimes when you serve on various committees, you have to be ready to step up and step in, especially when you're saying you want to be a part of the team. So I'm going to call Brother David Montgomery up. He said that his voice is gone, so he says that he can't speak right now. But we have Third VP Roberts, who is unavailable for this evening. He had a family emergency, who also serves as our political action chair. So I will go ahead and read his report, Now, we also have Reverend Shepherd. You're on the committee, right? So why don't you come on up and give the report for political action. Okay, your daughter can do it? Okay. Everybody's scared to do a report. Okay, I'll go ahead and do the report. All right, Third VP Roberts, very successful candidate tonight. Over 15 candidates or representatives for Congress, Ohio House of Representatives, Montgomery County Commission, Clerk of Courts, and Juvenile Court Judge participated in the forum. He participated in the Ohio Conference Lobby Day, met with the leadership from the Ohio House of Representatives, Ohio Senate, the Ohio Civil Rights Commission, had a special meeting with the representative from Senator Rob Portman's office to talk about his support of the Voting Rights Act. We were selected as one of four cities by the Popper Foundation to host community forums on the judiciary. Two community forums held, one in Dayton, and we also held one in Huber Heights. More than 30 participants attended each of the events. Very successful GOTV. We made thousands of phone calls. And on election day, we gave 39 people rides to the polls. And that's what it's about on the political action side. So I move for adoption of Third VP Roberts' report. Moved by Chairman Cordner.
Second.
Second by First VP Brown. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion carried. Now this time I'm gonna call up the youth representative. So President Destiny Ray Walker, who's the president of Little John Junior Youth Council, and is there gonna be a representative from the Dayton? Terrence? Okay, come on. So they're going to tag team this, and what they're going to do is they're going to read what they feel that they accomplished, and they will tag team to go one at a time. So, you know, this is Destiny Ray Walker's first year as president. She's doing an outstanding job. And what's your name again, sir?
Terrence Austin.
Terrence Austin.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what position are you playing?
I'm a representative for the youth council.
Representative for the youth council. All right, so I'm turning it over to these two fine people.
Thank you. I am Destiny Ray Walker, the president of the Little John Junior Youth Council. And this is what the Little John Junior NAACP participated in. They participated at AKA Founders Day program.
We have also provided school supplies at our back to school, stay in school event.
Went to the annual missionary Baptist Church West to provide school supplies to their youth.
We also attended the NAACP 107th Annual Convention for Training and Development Purposes.
We adopted one family for Christmas.
As well as donated toys to the Catholic Charities Tyke Shop.
Participated in the Feast of Giving at Dayton Convention Center. This was the 9th year in a row.
We will be participating in the WDAO Feast of Love event.
Balance in Bank 1.
$1,064.65 We've conducted several voter registration drives at the following events, including the MLK March,
Moms Against Guns,
the Joe Madison Speaking Engagement,
African American Wellness Walk,
Zick's Family Pharmacy Customer Appreciation Day,
City of Dayton Back to School Stay in School Event,
Central State University Homecoming,
Movie Opening of Birth of a Nation.
We have also participated in the Democracy Awakening demonstration in Washington, D.C.
Participated in the Anniversary Death Program of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King.
This is our report. Move for adoption.
It's probably moved and second by Chairman Cordner, second by John Chapman. Questions? Hold on. All those in favor, signal by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carried. Now, it's not easy as young folks to get up and speak before people, but did you see how he kind of helped her along the road? That's called mentoring 101. Let's give them a round of applause. Outstanding job. Thank you. Now we're going to hear from the Move Forward Thurgood Marshall NAACP High School Chapter and their report. I see the advisor, Lieutenant Colonel retired Claudia L. Mason is going to give the report. And I just want to tell you that she is a visionary, you know, and she's someone that when she started working, in fact, when she retired from the military, she started working for the Dean Unit NAACP as a volunteer, serving as the chair of our Armed Services and Veteran Affairs Committee. Then she went on to get a job at Thurgood Marshall High School, where she saw a need and got involved with the JROTC program. And then not only did she get involved in that program, but now she's over leadership development for JROTC. Probably about 2 years ago or so, she came to me and she said, "Derek, I want to start a NAACP chapter at Thurgood Marshall." And I said, "You know what? That's something I've been wanting to do ever since I've been president, is have someone in your high school chapter." But it's her vision that came to fruition, as you heard in my report on February 20th of this year, to have chartered the first high school chapter in the state of Ohio's history. So I just want to make certain that we go on record to say she's a visionary, and we appreciate your leadership, and look forward to you continuing to help these. So, Advisor Mason.
Thank you. I'm Claudia Mason, the advisor for the Thurgood Marshall High School chapter. We chartered by the NAACP Board of Directors in February of the 20th of February of this year. One of our first major events was attending the 107th annual NAACP convention. I mentioned that because we didn't have to pay a dime because we got a lot of contributions from my church, Corinthian Baptist Church. So there is a reverend out here supporting what we're doing with the NAACP. I was just taken aback by the support I got from Corinthian. I had asked for $500, I got $1,300. So it was a blessing, and I'm very grateful. Also, the Dayton Unit chapter donated as well. I want to thank them. So I was able to take two students that, it was a blessing, it was in Cincinnati. So we had a surplus after all that fundraising. But anyway, we were able to take two young people from Thurgood Marshall that had never been at a hotel. Just being around college age kids and seeing what business casual is, and just being exposed to the speakers that were there was a huge deal, and it made a huge impact on them. So I hope to bring more students to the next annual convention. So going to that convention is huge. Our chapter became the first NAACP high school chapter in the history of the state of Ohio, recognized by the Dayton, thanks to the efforts of President Ford. We were recognized by the Dayton City Commission, the Montgomery County Commission, the Ohio House of Representatives, the Ohio Senate, the Governor, the Ohio delegation of the U.S. Congress, as a reputable civic engagement organization worthy of replication. We participated in the Dayton Peace Museum, Teens Inventing Peaceful Solutions. This is something that we're partnering with the Dayton Peace Museum, and I think that's important for our students to get outside of the building and meet people from all over the city. They are learning conflict resolution techniques, and frankly, meeting other young people outside of Thurgood, which is always good. They get to share their personal stories and learn that some of the struggles they have, kids in Oakwood have the same struggles, believe it or not. But conflict resolution is a big part of that. We honored Thurgood Marshall as our chapter's Peace Hero during the Dayton International Peace Museum annual Peace Heroes Walk. It was a beautiful day in Dayton, and we take for granted some of the leaders that we have, the namesakes of our high school. A lot of students are attending Thurgood Marshall and they have no idea who Thurgood Marshall is. So that's a mission of a chapter, that they understand who Thurgood Marshall is. So we had a really nice turnout, about 12 young ladies. I'm trying to get males involved, but the ladies seem to come out in full force. Honor Thurgood Marshall as our peace hero. And most recently, we attended the Evening of Justice and Peace. This was organized by the Dayton Peace Literacy Foundation. It was an event held at the Victory Theater. Two authors of very renowned books written by about Thurgood Marshall were there, and they shared, it was basically, if you ever watched C-SPAN, and it was like a book notes talk, powerful event for them to attend. So I want to thank Derek for his support and for all the leaders and frankly for everybody's support, because I don't think our chapter would be here if it weren't for the members of this unit and also the members of this community. So thank you. And I move that. Do I need to do
that? No.
Okay.
We are on that report, yes.
I do?
Yeah.
I move that my report be adopted. Thank you. So
moved. Moved by who's that? John Chapman. Second by Dr. Carl Moreland. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye. Those opposed, motion carried. This next group is going to be our committee reports, and we're going to move all the committee reports at the end. So you need to come inside this order. Ilona Beans, who's the chairperson of our communications, press and publicity, is next. Then Marvine Mitchell. I'll read her report on her behalf. She's not here. Community coordination. And then after that, Scott Sliver, who is unable to attend this evening as well. He's the chairperson of our social media connection. And then after that, Cedric L. McGee, who's the chairperson of our AXO youth program. So Chair Lady Beans. And then I'm gonna go down because she wants to show you something on the screen here. So as she's speaking, we're gonna put something on the screen.
Blessings and peace to all the members and friends and community of the Dayton unit of the NAACP. My name is Ilona Beans, and I've been serving with communication and press publicity. Okay, my sister said it was okay. For a year. This is the second year for me. The monthly meeting for the reports for 2016, monthly meeting flyers. January, Reverend David Fox held for decisions when to use less lethal devices. Better word was President's Forum for Consequences for Life Crisis. In March, Marvina Mitchell, Career Job Fair. April, Loretta Williams, Moving Forward Together. May, Rosa Smith, Family Dentistry, Birth to Elderly Years. June, Roland Winborn, Ask the Question, Our Chamber of Commerce Ensuring Our Future Prosperity. July, the Second President's Forum covering NAACP National Convention. August, Deborah Smith, Let's Get Our House in Order. September, Tom Roberts, the Candidates Night, the local candidates. In October, we had a unit election process. Also in October, Chair Lou Dale, the annual Federal Freedom Fund banquet. November, the Dayton unit held the election of officers. November the 28th, President held a briefing with the Dayton Police Department. And of course, it brings us up today, our annual meeting. Well, also there was awards. There were two ads that would support our President's Awards. He received an Outstanding Community Support and Business Award. And also the second ad was the Carmel Bernardine Community Service Award. Of course, this year for the Freedom Fund banquet, we published two covers for the 2016. The first one was to depict the U.S. Capitol building, and the second was the Martin Luther King Memorial statue. Also, as you remember in the President's report, the Dayton unit was one of the only four cities to host the community, the dialogue with judicial reform. So in summary, the design layouts for the monthly meeting flyers were 12, for one for each month. There was a total of 15. Two covered the unit election, and also the unit voting at polls and a Freedom Fund banquet. Also, there were two design layouts, President's Awards, 10 designs proposed for the 2016 Freedom Fund banquet. Two of those were approved. A special election to sponsor presentation, which was the judicial reform. Also in 2016, there was an initiative to foster timely distribution of monthly meeting flyers. Our community chairs, a month in advance, submitted their topics and name of speakers. The flyer was drafted, provided to the president for review and approval. The goal was 7 to 10 days prior to the meeting. Our accomplishment for 2016, we met that goal about 80%. I thank each person for their, committee person for their support, and also hopefully in the 2017 year, there could be an improvement of 100% in getting out our flyers in a timely manner. I move for adoption.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. That concludes my report.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Yeah, so all of the committee reports we're going to move for up at the end of that. The next report is going to be Marvin Chairlady, Marvin Mitchell, Community Coordination. And then read a couple of the items that she actually has been engaged in this year. Her vision statement, she came up with a vision statement to develop forums to establish open dialogue pertaining to community issues, partnership with the Montgomery County Development Services Workforce Development Department and the City of Dayton Economic Development Department. First annual career job fair, we had that back in March of this year. There were 279 participants in attendance. 63 interviews were conducted on site. 42 were hired in full-time positions. 11 were placed in part-time permanent positions. And 103 were enrolled in the WIOA TANF training programs. So this is our first job fair, and as you can see, it yielded in looks like a total of 42 full-time positions and then 11 part-time positions. So a total of 53 jobs as it relates to the NAACP's efforts on doing a job fair. Secondly, partnership with the Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, Dayton Alumni Chapter, Social Action Committee, Voter Registration, Voters Education and Awareness Initiative, continued partnership with the Panhellenic, that's Greek organizations, other social organizations, coordinated monthly meetings with their community liaison to review their calendar of events in order to explore possibilities of partnering and or assisting with their events, conducted membership drives, and also provided updates to assure which the Dayton NAACP is addressing within the community. And then she also is doing partnership with other ethnic organizations that she's gonna get involved in 2017. Now, our next committee is our social media connection. That is Chairman Scott Sliver. And he was appointed as chair of the committee in August of 2016. Consolidated two Twitter accounts for us into one easily identifiable account name, which is at Dayton Unit NAACP. Increased the number of accounts following us on Twitter from 49 to 149, which was a 210% increase just since September of this year. Established a direct connection with the Nationals NAACP Twitter account, having been mentioned and retweeted by them. You know, our Twitter account has also been mentioned and retweeted by WHIO, WDTN, Fox 45, ABC 22, Dayton Daily News, Honda of Ohio, Jerome Reed, who's our regional director, and the judge producer, and the producer for Judge Mathis, among others. Promoted regular monthly meetings and activities voter registration, Freedom Fund banquet, and brought attention to numerous other concerns. 11/23 to 11/29, we sent out 19 tweets and/or messages reaching 590 accounts, leaving 2,996 impressions. So if you have a Twitter account, please follow us on Twitter, and then you can also follow us on Facebook as well. So Chairman McGee, Axel.
Thank you, Mr. President. AXO, if you do not know, it stands for Afro-Academic, Cultural, Technological, and Scientific Olympics. And we've held meetings every Tuesday from 5:30 to 7 o'clock at Thurgood Marshall High School in the year of 2015. We've also had a consistency of 5 to 10 students on average per meeting. This year, we've been meeting at Duke Ellis Institute. Our local competition was held April 9th of 2016. 7 students were awarded local medals. Christina Streety, Stivers, in the category of poetry performance. Casey Turney, Stivers in engineering. And since I'm an engineer, I got to mentor him myself. Kier Dewberry, Thurgood Marshall, he was a biochemistry. Craig Jackson, he was a music instrumental contemporary. And Corey Smith, she was in music vocal classical. Nequa Marshall did poetry written, and Montana Limehouse did entrepreneurship. So we have some of those students coming back this year. Christina Streeter, she's went off to college, and Nequa Marshall is also a college student. And if there are any AXO students here tonight, I'd like you to stand and your parents just to be recognized. And also, I'd like to recognize our longtime chairman and co-chairman this year, Dr. Carl Moeller. Had over 20, 30 years of youth ministry, and he does a lot of things behind the scenes that a lot of us do not know. And if you want to join AXO, I have applications here. Thanks.
Thank you, Chairman McGee. And the next set is going to be Chairman Willie Terrell, coming this order, Chairlady Donna Williams, followed by Chairlady Loretta Williams. Chairman Willie Terrell is the chairman of our scholarship committee. So he's up next, and he's going to give his report.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Let's do that again. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And there you go, and happy holidays to all of you. On our report, we have the 2017 recipients as well as the 2016. Speedway, we had Ms. Dewberry for Laverne Gooding, Amari Smith, Jesse O. Gooding Reward, Randy Smith, Malia Williams, Queen J. Peter Thornton, and the Derek L. Ford. And Mr. Ford, I'm not sure if you know, but Terrence is the winner of your scholarship, the guy that was up here a minute. Stand up again, Terrence. I want everybody to see his face. And I think we might have a few deltas in the house. Those of you that went to the Peppermint Ball, check this out. Terrence is a person that created that cover. I'm predicting that he's going to come back with the gold from the national. And the president is always saying, who are these scholarship recipients? We never see them. Well, there's one right there. Thank you, Terrence. for supporting the NAACP. The 2016 recipients, these individuals have already received their checks and they have already went off to school. Laverne Gooding went to Lillian Stoger, Jesse Gooding, Amari Bazaar, Malio Williams went to Adidra Johnson, and the Derek L. Ford went to Angela Brand. Thank you for supporting the scholarship, and Mr. President, thank you for allowing me to serve.
Thank you.
And I move my report.
Oh, no, we're doing this at the end.
Oh, at the end, okay.
Yes, sir. All right, Chairlady Williams is next. That's Dinah Williams, followed by Chairlady Loretta Williams. And then after that, it's gonna be Chairlady Dale for Freedom Fund. And I will give her report. And Reverend David Fox after that, followed by Chris Cortner.
Good evening, everyone. This year, I had basically had a limited time because I had started several jobs right after retirement. And I was given a nice little job with the NAACP in reference with President Derek Ford and also with the help of Ms. Betsy. Miss Betsy
Seiler.
Seiler, thank you. And they gave me my assignments as far as calling different members and encouraging them to renew their memberships. I have to read all this stuff real quick and sit down. Membership is up 7.29% versus the previous year. We had 232 new members November the 16th, year to date. We encourage family, friends, and executive committee members to renew their memberships throughout the year. As we did, we called our members and also we tried to have them to add their cell phone numbers and emails so we can further keep in contact. And there were 14 fully paid life members in November 2016 and collaborated with Betsy and President Ford in reaching out to these members who needed to renew their membership, as I just said, by giving personal calls and updating mail and cell phone updates for future notifications and upcoming events. Attended the MLK breakfast and musicals in February, as well as offered support to the Little John Jr. Youth Council. Was able to secure 5 memberships while working at Myers. Many people asked me about joining the organization due to wearing my NAACP shirt. It happens to be the same color of my uniform when I was working there. And I had ran out of my clothes, they were dirty, so I just wore my shirt one day. And I didn't know that representing and wearing a t-shirt would increase the membership. And yes, and so that was really a great deal. And I attended the NAACP 107th annual convention in Cincinnati, Ohio. Met a lot of people, and it was a really nice turnout. And got information from the national membership chair. Assisted the Political Action Committee on its voter registration drive. Volunteered on the Freedom Fund Committee, and was able to secure a few new ads as far as businesses as well. And it's not too late to get out and get on board with the NAACP because right now is the best time to do it. We are exchanging different political leadership right now, and we need to be involved in anything that goes on Capitol Hill. We cannot just sit back and ignore anything. So this is a great time to get involved, renew your membership, encourage your friends, and just jump on board. Thanks a lot, everybody.
Thank you, Trinity Williams. Shelley Loretta Williams, education.
Thank you so much. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I have the pleasure and honor of serving as chairperson of Education Committee, and I wanted to throw this out at you. As a chairperson, I need a committee. So the purpose for our focus for 2016 was primarily to build relationships. This is my first year serving, build relationships, and to assess the current status of our Dayton public school system. We did that by collaborating with our former superintendent. We had community night where the participants participated in table talks. And some of the primary, each table was presented with particular questions, but two things that were of importance. One was attendance. For 2014-2015, 41% of our students missed 10 days or more. So these are sort of challenges that we face right now. And the other, issue of importance with the list of problems that the participants identified. One was the lack of parent support and involvement, lack of discipline with our students, teachers spending more time to maintain order in the classrooms, watered down curriculum, and students having to study too much for tests. So these are some of the issues we have to face as we try to build relationships with our school systems and try to provide support. So I'm asking anyone who's out here, or if you have anyone that you know who might be interested in serving on the Education Committee, I would love to work with you. So if you'll see me before the night is over, we could do that. And I'm finished, and thank you so very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Shirley Williams. Shirley Dill, I thought I'd seen her come in. So we'll come back to her. So Chairman Fox, if you can come up. Chairman Fox, Criminal Justice Committee. And we'll come back to Chairman Edel. Chairman Fox is Chairman of the Criminal Justice Committee.
Put some glasses on. All right. All right, the Criminal Justice Committee moderated a Dayton unit in the NAACP monthly community meeting entitled Deciding When to Use Less Lethal Devices, and interacted with local police administrators, including Chief Richard Beal, Chief Eric Wilson, and Sheriff Plummer. Interface with Dayton Police, Trotwood Police, and Sheriff Department in matters concerning complaint process and misconduct. Manage high volume of criminal justice inquiries, 140 to be exact, and formal complaint investigations of 54, leading to increased customer service and satisfaction. Partnered with President Ford to ensure Sheriff Department conducted a fair investigation, leading to the demotion of the jail administrator, planning coordinated active shooter training for the Dayton alumni of chapter of the Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, partner with President Ford to ensure quarterly meetings.
Shelley Dell, we're trying to get through.
Thank you, Mr. President. So nice of you to call on me. But I want to talk to you all personally, because I know you understand, especially if you are a grandparent I got a grandson that's sick, and I just got off the road. Parents supposed to have gotten home about 3:30. They got home at 6:30. So here I am, still trying to hold up my promise to Mr. President. And I'll have to go back as soon as I finish. Okay, I'm gonna call it number one committee, Freedom Fund. Y'all can call your committee what you want to. Number one, Freedom Fund committee. We were really happy, pleased, and really excited to have, as our guest speaker this year, the Honorable Judge Greg Mathis. He was our keynote speaker. And if you were there, I'm sure you had a treat. But you see, these are the kinds of people and speakers that you get involved with when you are working with the NAACP. So I say that to hope that you will remember, start thinking about it for 2017. We'll have another great speaker that you won't want to miss. Okay, so let me count on you for that. Now, during all of that, we were able to raise over $150,000 for our Freedom Fund banquet. Now, this is up 26% versus previous years. Now, I'm going to give you the breakdown. Some of you might be able to read it from over there, but I appreciate your eyesight. For me, I'm going to read it from here. Our platinum level sponsors, we had two, just to give you an idea of the breakdown. And of course, in that particular area, we were down 50% as opposed to last year. But you know, like anything, sometimes you may go low or you may break even in a particular area, and then you'll have another area, as you will see, where we may go over. So, diamond level sponsor won, and of course, statistically, that was down 50%. Gold level sponsorship, we had 8. Now that was up 157% versus last year. Silver sponsorship 22, so we got an up here. We were up 10% as opposed to last year. Bronze level 16, that was up 6.67 versus previous year. We have a lot of organizations that participate and support us. We still need others, we need all of them. So if your organization did not make it this year, I'm looking forward to seeing your organization in this list for 2017. Organization level sponsorship, 41, and we were up 20.59. So we had a great support in that area. Souvenir journal ads are not included in the corporate sponsorship. 87, up 6.9 versus last year. So that kind of gives you the breakdown. The only thing I'm going to say to you and ask you to say to your friends is we had a great year. Our enrollment was up. More so than last year. We want to continue to increase our participants. So I'm going to tell you the date of that, 2017, but you can, it's always the fourth Friday in October. Did you have that? But anyway, you can remember that, can't you? Not, you know, yeah. Give me a little something. Give me a little something. Let me know you heard. 2017. So I look forward to inviting you out again. We really need your support.
My name is Ludell, and I'm kind of like your president. I'm just a worker. I'm here to serve. So call me, and you can even call me late too, because I don't always stress that. But I'll take it. I'll take it. Anytime. And that number is 478-2762. Especially if you're calling me about a membership, and the least of all, you're calling me because you want to make a donation or you want to buy a table. I'll wake up with you at 2 o'clock in the morning. So let's do it. Let's continue to work for NAACP. Thank you.
Thank you, Trinity Dill. Chairman Courtner, is this your phone up here? Chairman Courtner, and that's going to be followed, like I said, by Attorney Kitty Page and Chairman Roland Winburn.
First of all, I want to thank my paralegal, stand up. That's my paralegal, Kathy Parsons. She's been my right arm, my right ear, and my right leg. So I forgot her last year, so that's the reason why she's holding up that right side, because she really gave it to me. So yeah, that's what you get. I got the... We investigated 84 cases, and that was up 127%. It's really not getting any better, I'll put it that way. It's not getting any better. We settled 51 cases. We had 2 cases at the VA, and they're the worst. We got 2 cases with Veteran. We got 12 with the Ohio Civil Rights Commission, and that encompasses a lot when we go to the House Civil Rights Commission, because that means we have mediation, and we have to go through a mediation process. So that's kind of involved. We had 2 cases with Pickwa High School, 16 cases with the local labor and industrial employers, 2 cases with Northmont Elementary, 3 with the EEOC, and 12 housing complaints. And we get a bunch more, but that's just a microcosm of what we actually have to do in the office. It's a lot of things, and I'm glad that Kathy came aboard, because she has made it so much easier. She has updated our computer system, And that makes it really, really good. And some of our forms, she has reevaluated and re-edited some of our forms, and that's a great help. So I'm super glad I have her support, and she's really my rock. And so I thank you, everyone. I'll see y'all later.
Thank you, Chairman Courtner. Okay, Attorney Kim Page, I will read his report, and then if Chairman Winburn can make his way. Attorney Kim Page, who is over our legal redress, along with outside counsel, if I go the right way here, and along with outside counsel, we help to monitor any and all litigation throughout the year, beyond the need to formally respond to one set of charges filed incorrectly in an error by an individual clearly struggling with personal issues. There is no outstanding litigation on note detailing any claim with merit against the Dayton Unit NAACP. Along with Reverend Fox and his leadership, we met with the Huber Heights mayor regarding complaints of police harassment of young men of color. Also provided legal support around a myriad of individual complaints that were reported directly to our Dayton unit. These reports included claims of unfair dismissal from employment, allegations of unfair treatment by both the local and federal judiciary and having active court matters, inappropriate racial animus in the workplace involving a local sheriff's department, and finally supporting the president's office with a letter directly to the person responsible for leaving offensive language on a unit's voicemail, along with a letter including similar harassing, racially insensitive complaints about the NAACP and African American community. Chairman Winburn, Economic Development.
This year, we started off in April. Our business activity started off in April this year when I was appointed chairman of the Economic Development Committee. After that, we began to form this particular committee with identifying individuals who would become members of the Economic Development Committee, and we did that all the way up through October of the year. In June of this current year, we made a presentation to the general membership regarding the activities and the relationship that chambers of commerce have in our community and in developing prosperity and developing jobs and business opportunities in the community. After that, we've held two meetings this past year, one in November and in December, where we began to organize around the national, state, and local economic development goals and how we're going to recognize those goals and turn those goals into goals here that we can address in the local community, making those goals relevant and important for our particular region and in the Dayton-Miami Valley region. We've had several partnership opportunities with the Dayton Chamber of Commerce and Fifth Third Bank this year to develop and have discussions regarding economic development and opportunities that relate toward jobs and other business development and expansion opportunities. Some of our efforts and our initiatives are going to be around financial and economic education, promoting racial equity and diversity in the community, career advancements, monitoring bank policies and financial institutions, promoting community development and economic development, and also empowering our community to be able to address developing businesses and expanding businesses in our area, and also to develop our infrastructure, our financial infrastructure. So those are many of the activities. We're going to get together in January once again to begin to look at the goals, and again, as I said before, to make those goals more relevant to our community and have more focus on how we want to develop economic development opportunities in our community. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman Winburn. In this order, Chairlady Smith for Housing Committee Chair, followed by Reverend Ayo Ongundu Ulay, International Affairs, and lastly, Demetrius H. Rush, Chairman of Get Out to Vote, and that'll probably be read by Arnetta Gary, because I do not see Chairman Rush in here. So in that order, and this will be the last of our committee reports.
First of all, good evening to everyone.
Good evening.
Glad to see so many people here tonight. My name is Deborah Smith. I'm the chairperson of housing for the Dayton chapter of NAACP. Just to give you some highlights of 2016, we had another cleanup, Five Oaks neighborhood. This is, I think, our third year doing that. I'm a chairperson of the committee. However, there's one person on the in NAACP that helps me. His name is Cedric McGee. I wanted to recognize him. Would you please stand? And as I said last year, it's a lot of work. And I know people here do not litter. They don't throw out trash. But please talk to your neighbors. Let's just keep our neighborhoods clean and free of debris. This was in conjunction with the Five Oaks Neighborhood Association. The city of Dayton was there to collect all the trash for us. Wright State students, UD students helped as well. The second bullet, first-time homeowners. The Ownership Center of Greater Dayton now offers qualified buyer assistance for down payments up to like 20%. So if individuals need help with their down payments on new purchases, I would suggest you contact them. They're located at 205 East First Street, and that's the Homeowners Center of Greater Dayton. The next thing, I conducted or I hosted a workshop entitled Let's Get Our Houses in Order back in August, where I had three representatives from the city of Dayton come out and speak to all of our members concerning trash pickup, you know, bulky waste, when to set your bulky waste out. You can't set it out too soon because, you know, just sets out there for weeks at a time, so there are certain times you had to set your trash out for pickup. Also, one of the representatives spoke about housing code violations. So if you don't want housing code violations, you may want to, I don't know, you can call the city of Dayton probably and get that information from them, or maybe on their website. Thirdly, the individual spoke about assisting homeowners with homeowner repairs. So, you know, there are free services out there. So that was a very good workshop. And the mayor, the next bullet, the mayor's fund for neighborhoods. If you have a neighborhood and you're working hard in your neighborhood and you're taking pride in your neighborhood, the mayor will issue a grant for $1,000 to help you. Some of the winners for 2016 was McCook Fields Neighborhood Association. They used the money to help have a reading program. The Twin Towers Neighborhood Association had an Easter egg hunt with their, that's how they used their money. And so that's a very good program, but the only thing about it, the deadline was the 16th of December. I don't know if they've extended it or not. So you can check with the city. And lastly, the Dayton area is getting $8.2 million to combat building blight, to get rid of some of these vacant properties in our neighborhoods. And that money is going to be divided between the city of Dayton, Trotwood, Harrison Township, Jefferson Township, Riverside, Kettering, Clayton, and Miami Township. And then according to the report, 70 to 75% of the money will go to the city of Dayton, however. And so far, the city of Dayton has about 6,600 vacant structures that still need to be torn down. But they've torn down up to about 2,200 thus far. And as you know, when we have eyesores in our community, people stop investing in our communities, and people don't want to buy in our communities. So report these houses to the appropriate people, the city of Dayton. And that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you, Chairlady Smith, Housing. Reverend Ayo on Udo Ule International Affairs.
Good evening, everybody. Glad to be here one more time. Tomorrow is not promised. The next minute is not promised. Grace of God. My report is on international affairs, and I will be going with information as we have it on the board. Global climate change has a disproportionate impact on communities of color in the United States and around the world. NAACP Environmental and Climate Justice Program was created to educate and mobilize communities to address this human and civil rights issue. We're just trying to let everybody know that the global warming is serious. And for people not to take it serious, you know, it's just like playing with something that they're not supposed to play with. So we know that some of our leaders are kind of not challenged, you know, with this kind of situation because they don't really know things about it. So, but we know that it's actually affecting people of color all over the world, and NAACP created that Environmental and Climate Justice Program just to educate folks about what is actually happening. Then NAACP will continue to support the efforts of citizens in any countries with African descendants in their due process to elect leaders of their choice. This is very, very important in the sense that rigging elections and things of that nature and cases of nations with too many old leaders when we actually need some young leaders with some dynamic leadership. NAACP will continue to support, you know, efforts of the citizens, whoever they pick as their leader. NAACP is going to work with them, either on the islands, the Caribbean, in Nigeria, in South Africa, in wherever they are, you know, where people of color are. Then thirdly, NAACP continues to be a strong supporter of normalization with Cuba and its people at large. President Obama validated this by visiting the island of 11 million people. And the last presidential visit from an American president was 88 years ago. We thank God for President Obama because we prayed hard for him 8 years ago. And we're still praying for him until the last day that he comes out of that office. So one of the things that he has done as a leader is just to show his humanity to everybody all over the world. And he's well, well respected beyond this nation. I know what goes on beyond this United States. So I can tell that he's well respected outside the shores of this country. Now we have all the things going with Cuba and doors are going to open up and everything's going to be happening. Get your flight and go and visit. The last one is NAACP reviewing the United African States Constitution to see areas of mutual interest for the people of the United States. Dr. Godley, who is in charge of these international affairs in Washington, D.C., is monitoring the meetings in Ghana. There was a meeting October 20th in Ghana. And just to let you know, the president of the United African States is right here in Dayton, Ohio. His name is Victor Obashuyi. He's a member of St. Benedict de Moor. He's a deacon at St. Benedict de Moor. And he went to that meeting in Ghana. NAACP was supposed to have sent somebody out there. However, they couldn't get somebody there quick enough, but they are studying everything. And one of the most important things I want to share with you is this. 20 years ago, it cost me about $2 to make a phone call to my, you know, homeland, which is Nigeria. But now it only cost me 20 cents. And the reason was, Gaddafi put a satellite up. And when you call from here, it hits the satellite and it goes down in the country in Africa. $500 million savings that companies in the United States and Europe were making. They got rid of him. Why? Because he gave a whole lot to the people. Free education, free medical attention, free everything. So we have to be mindful of the fact that all these African states have come together and they want to participate in business in this country. And they're looking at you and me. We want to put a distribution point right here in Dayton that will provide jobs for folks. So people, United African States is alive and well, and NAACP is going to support it 100%. That's all I have.
Thank you, Chairman Abdul-Ule. Vice Chair Arnetta Gary for Get Out to Vote. This is the last committee report.
2 minutes. I can't read that fast. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
And happy holy days. God has been good to us. I would like to
talk about get out to vote. As you all know, we voted in November. And so this year, 2.5 million people voted for Hillary Clinton over Obama in 2012. Isn't that a wonderful thing? Let's give Hillary a hand clap, because we are stronger together. I attended the 107th National Convention, and it was all about get out to vote. We had classes. We worked diligently to ensure the passage of Issue 9. Let's give a hand clap for Chris Schott. We secured one life membership and 3 regular memberships this year. I also want to thank all of you who prayed for Mr. Rush, who had a bout with a spell this summer, but he has come through. Thank God. We assisted with the Meet the Candidates night in conjunction with the Political Action Committee, held in September of 2016. We did a lot of phone banking and door knocking to encourage people to vote. And it's still not over. We want to trump poverty. How about that? Let's trump poverty. And we want to thank everyone that got out and vote. But we have a primary coming up in the spring of the year. So we need new registrants. And like she said, we got to stay on top of Capitol Hill. Because we the people, our lives matter, and our votes do count. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Okay. This is my entertaining motion to accept all the committee reports.
So moved.
Second. Moved by Senator McGee, second by Vermilio. Questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion carried. Unfinished business. We only have one piece of unfinished business, and that is we still have the house over here on West 1st Street, and we're going to see what we can do with that sometime in the coming year. We had an opportunity to get a marker from the city of Dayton, and since I see 3 of the power brokers here, 3 of the commissioners here, I guess we might talk to them about that at some other time. And so that's the only unfinished business that we had. New business. Under new business, we always at this meeting vote on our national board representatives. And for the sake of time, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna say these names to you, and I'm gonna powwow with the executive committee members during dinner so we can come up with who, in fact, we're gonna vote for. And the reason I say that, last year was a little bit easier because there was only 7 candidates. This year, there are actually 8 candidates, but only 7 can be selected from this body, as well as in Region 3, and those are at large positions. And then whereas in Region 3, there are 3 representatives, and only 1 can be elected by this body. So I have the Dayton Unit NAACP's ballot. I also have the Little John Junior Youth Council's ballot. And all of us will powwow during dinner. Dayton Youth Council, do you all have a ballot? Okay, because that's supposed to be done at this meeting, so we can talk about that as well. And Move Forward Third Good Marshall High School Chapter, did you all receive a ballot? No? Okay, all right. So, that's something we have to do at this meeting. Is to elect board members. No award presentations, but before I even do that, let me just go through the rest of the 2007 calendar events. I actually
emailed each one of the committee chairs, the exec committee, an email about next year's calendar events. So if you have not responded, I would appreciate it if you would respond so we can get our calendar together. The Dayton Unit NAACP 51st inaugural ceremony will take place January 12, 2017. So for all of you who were elected back on November the, I believe that was November the 6th, Sunday, November the 6th, to offices, then the inaugural ceremony is going to take place on January the 12th, 2017. And then our next executive committee meeting date will be January the 17th. So that's everybody who was actually elected. Once again, on November the 6th, 2016, if you were elected on that particular day, then your first executive committee meeting will be on January 17th, at which time the president will make appointments to various committee chairs. Now, our next monthly meeting, monthly community meeting, which is open to the public, is scheduled for January the 23rd. And then, so getting back up to award presentation, but before I do that, I do want to acknowledge Judge Mia Wortham-Spells, if you can stand and be recognized. Straight from the NAACP, you've been with us for a very long time, advocating for civil and human rights, and now she can do it from the bench. And then also we have Commissioner Joy B. Williams, please stand and be recognized. Longtime friend. Commissioner Jeff Mims, longtime friend. And Commissioner Chris Shaw, who also came from the ranks of NAACP, longtime friend. So, and I'm proud to say that each one of those three gentlemen over there who sits on the commission, I was able to secure each one of their life memberships. So, over the course of time, you know, all it takes is to ask the question, would you like to become a life member? So I would encourage all of you all, just like you heard from our committee chair, membership committee chair, Diana Williams, please, you can see her about getting a membership. She has forms. So with that, I do have a few awards, I think I'm going to do these awards here. And I'm going to announce your name. I'm going to read what it says, but we will take pictures during the eating portion so that everybody can get something to eat. But you can come up and then I will hand this to you. So the first one is going to be for the Dayton Unit NAACP Executive Committee Award. The officers, executive committee members, and members of the Dayton Unit NAACP presents this award to Eric L. Ellington Sr. For your dedication, availability, and willingness to attend every executive committee meeting for the entire year of 2016. From my perspective, many organizations love to have people like you on their team. You have demonstrated leadership amongst your peers and exemplified the true meaning of the word committed. Keep up the great work. The officers, executive committee members, and members of the Dayton Unit NAACP commend you on this 19th day of December 2016. We, the undersigned, do hereby acknowledge said efforts and sincerely thank you for your contributions to the community and the Dayton Unit NAACP. And the other person who's getting the same award, and if you can make your way up here, it's also, well, he's not here, but Tom Roberts, our third VP and political director chair, is also receiving this award, has attended every executive committee member, every executive committee meeting for the year of 2016. Congratulations. The next one is going to be for, and both these are the same as well, and this is for general membership. And this is Dayton Unit NAACP General Membership Award. The officers, executive committee members, and members of the Dayton Unit of the National Association for the Advancement of the Country presents this award to, and these both read the same. It says, for your dedication, availability, and willingness to attend every general membership meeting for the entire year 2016. And these awards are going to go to Secretary Claire May Thompson and Committee Chair Cedric L. McGee. Come on. Thank you.
This next award is called the Stellar Attendance Award. And this is for individuals who have attended every executive committee meeting and general membership meeting in the year of 2016. And these awards are going to go to Reverend David Fox and First Lady Jean A. Ford. Every executive member meeting and general membership meeting for the entire year of 2016. And we're going to call these the Stellar Attendance Awards. Give it up for them. And then there's also another Stellar Award, but this is actually signed up, Stellar Attendance Award. This is actually signed off by Reverend Herman E. Brown and Secretary Claire Mae Thompson, and that's actually presented to me because I also attended every meeting in exhibit, both meetings of the year, General Committee and Executive Committee. And we have a Volunteer of the Year Award. It says Dayton Unit NAACP Volunteer of the Year Award. Presents this, Dayton Unit NAACP presents this award to Kathy L. Parson for assisting the Labor and Industry Committee and Criminal Justice Committee with investigating over 100 cases from August 2015 to November 2016. You have contributed greatly to the overall success of the Dayton Unit NAACP by organizing files, creating forms, creating a database, and data entry. Provide prospective meeting organizations would like to have you, or would love to have people like you on their team. Keep up the great work. Congratulations. And the next award is for the Committee Chair of the Year Award. Dayton Unit NAACP Committee Chair of the Year Award. It says the officers, executive committee members, and members of the Dayton Unit NAACP presents this award to Cedric L. McGee for your dedication, support, availability, and willingness to help the president of the Dayton Unit NAACP at any given time without questioning why. That's very important. You know, this gentleman right here, I can count on him. If I talk to Cedric, can you do this? Cedric, can you do that? Cedric, can you run here? He, you know, not one time has he ever said, well, Derek, why? Or Derek, maybe in a minute. And it's always, when can I help you, Mr. President? And I really, really appreciate that. You have a mild mannered, meek, yet giving spirit, having a vision to collectively assist all four of our youth organizations. From my perspective, many organizations love to have people like you on your team. You are truly a team player. Congratulations. And then we have two membership awards to give out. This individual, always tries to keep up with me. He's competitive, that's what he is. And that is none other than Brother Willie H. Terrell Jr. He actually got a life membership for a Sala, and then also got a life member, a silver life membership last year for his church, but this year he turned around and got the Golden Heritage life membership for his church. So he's a man about business and a man on the move. Brother Willie H. Terrell Jr., congratulations. And stay on here for a second, Brother Willie. Due to him selling memberships all the way from the national office, he actually has a NAACP Million Dollar Club Award for selling over $1,000 worth of memberships. Congratulations. And the other person receiving this same award, NAACP Million Dollar Club Award, is going to be Ms. Ina Green from Summit Christian Church. She works her church every year getting memberships. And I wish that we had more faithful people at their respective churches to do the same. Every year we can count on her to say in July, come on out, let's do a membership drive for the whole month of July. And I challenge any of you who at your churches to do the same. She does this every year, and we appreciate you. And she reminded me, this is the fourth year. All right. And then I had one more award, but I don't see the individual here. And we will try to get him this coming Friday at our NAACP mixer that we're going to have at the Taste Creative Cuisine. So in Trotwood. So that's this coming Friday. We're going to have a little get out. Instead of having a meeting, you don't have to sit through a meeting. You can just come out, celebrate with the Dayton Union NAACP for end of the year mixer. So with that. I do not make certain I do not see him, and I don't. Hold on. Yes, I do. I have to look over to the right there. All right. This has been near and dear to my heart for a little while, and I really wanted to do this a few years back, but every year, as we know, as you see, I have my Oakland Raider colors on right now. We are in the playoffs, so and I have my Oakland Raider pin right here, and so I'm very happy that since 2002, this is our first year making the playoffs since 2002. So when I think about that, during the same time frame is football season. So I really wanted to honor this individual during a Freedom Fund banquet, but has been unable to because of football season. So with that, I would like to call up here Maurice G. Douglas Sr. Maurice Douglas is a graduate from Trotwood High School, and he also went on to play in the NFL. Now he went back to his high school, Trotwood, and coached for a number of years. And then now he's coaching in a different community up in Springfield, Ohio. So this is what this says, and Maurice, we certainly appreciate you because at the end of the day, everybody don't make it to where the Lord has allowed you to go. And for you to be able to deposit rich blessings back into our youth, that was really important. I think that really means a lot. And what this says is it says, Dayton Union NAACP President's Award of Honor presented to Maurice G. Douglas Sr. in recognition of your distinguished career playing professional football in the National Football League, otherwise known as the NFL. As a coach and mentor who has changed the lives of young people through sports and education, your work in the Dayton and Springfield communities will exceed those playing on the field. In 2006, you led the Trotwood Rams to the playoffs for the first time in 25 years. And over 100 players you have coached have went on to play college football. It is because of these achievements that you are being recognized for this President's Award of Honor. You are truly a blessing to our community. We the people, our lives matter, our votes count. This is signed by myself, three vice presidents, Reverend Herman E. Brown, Rosie E.R. Smith, and Tom Roberts. And continue to do what you do in terms of mentoring these young men. They really need it nowadays. And whether or not we get it through sports, or whether or not we get it through education, you have done both. And we'll give you the opportunity to say a word, if you'd like to say a word.
Thank you all, Joy. Derek, thank you about him over there. No, thank you all. It is a true honor to be able to receive this award. But more than that, I'm thankful that God placed me in the position that he's placed me. Gave me favor with man and placed me in much royalty. He said that your gift will make way for me. And with that gift, I'll just try to do what he called me to do. Right now, I think we had 190-some kids that we put in school the last 15 years. This year's class, I think we have 12 seniors this year. I believe 9 of those kids are going to play football or go to school academically or athletically. The other 3 don't want to go in that route, but God has a different plan for them. But our thing is just to try to help as many kids as possible. God said if you sow a seed, that he'll bless you with your seed. Now, my son is a sophomore, and because of the seed that I've sowed in other people's lives, now God's allowed my son, 16 years old, he has 12 offers already. And so if you give him as a press down, shaking together, you'll add it to you. So I'm just telling you all, if you get an opportunity to sow seeds in these young men and women's lives, it may not seem like much, but all I am is an example of a guy who, I had a teammate of mine when I went to junior college out of Kansas. The coach had asked for a kid named Tony Costa. Tony was the player of the year in Ohio. He ain't keep fires. But coach said, if you don't take Mo, you're not going to get Tony because Tony's not going to stay. Well, that coach took a chance on me and stuck his neck out for me. And now I'm able to do the same thing for others. And that's why I continue to do that, because somebody took a chance on me. So if you have a young man or woman that's maybe struggling with some things today, don't give up on them. Just keep praying for them. Because my grandma prayed for me. I was a knucklehead. And I asked you, to the 2 guys over there, no. I cut up. But it wasn't too late. God, if he can do it for me, he can do it for you. And so if I can give you any advice or anything about your young men or women, don't hesitate to call me. If you need some help with a kid that just needs a chance, give me his tape, give me his film, give me a transcript on him, and I'll do what I can from the fall. I'm always here. Thank you all for letting me have a hand.
Thank you.
Thank you, man. Got that young man taking a picture.
Congratulations. Yes, sir. All right, so at this time, sorry for the lateness of the hour, but we've been going to eat. And I'll be speaking with, the food has already been blessed earlier, right?
Yes.
You didn't bless the food? Okay.
Father God, we thank you for this day again. We thank you, Lord, for this meeting. Now, Lord, we come and ask your blessing upon this physical food that our bodies about to receive. We pray that we nourish for our bodies and give us strength and need to continue to do your will. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
And so you can line up, get some meat. The meeting is not adjourned because we, as the NAACP, still take care of some business with these ballots. So, but everybody else, you can get up and eat. And we will eventually close the meeting now once we actually deal with our business with the election. Thanks.